In Creo Parametric, you can perform manual routing of pipelines. And if you're going to do that, you're going to need to set up line stock for the pipes that you want to use. Let's take a look at how to do that. I've got a piping assembly open. Let's go to Applications, Piping. And if you go to the Setup Overflow menu, you can get to the line stock command. This is going to open up the menu manager where you could edit existing line stock. For example, if I choose edit, here I can choose the hydraulic DN25 diameter nominal 25 stock. And here we have the different information inside of here. I'm going to cancel out of here because I am going to create three different kinds of line stock of my own. First for regular circular pipes, then for rectangular ducts and flexible hoses. To create the new one, let's click on the Create button. And you're going to enter the name of the line stock. And I'm going to call mine Schedule 80. And it's going to be for nominal pipe size of 4 inches. And in Europe and outside of the United States, they use DN for diameter nominal. And that's going to be a nominal diameter of 100 millimeters. Excuse me, not 100 inches. Let's hit the Enter key, and here we have the line stock dialog box. And this has three different tabs. I'm going to start on the first tab for line stock. And here's where you can enter in a different value for the stock number. Here we have our material, which is steel. For the grade, maybe I want to change this to, say, Schedule 80. For the material file, if you click this button, you will get to the folder with your materials. You've got the legacy Creo Parametric materials from Creo Parametric 3.0 and earlier. I'm going to go to the granted database that was added in Creo Parametric 4.0. Let's go to our ferrous metals. I'm going to grab cast steel and click open. And that way it's using that material file. For the cross section, I'm going to leave the default of circular, and we'll do a hollow pipe. You could also choose solid, but we actually want this for conveying fluids, so I'm going to choose hollow. For the pipe OD, this is for the data for this one. This is going to be actually a value of 4.5 for the OD, and the thickness for this one is 0.32. Let's take a look at where you can get this information. If you go to engineeringtoolbox.com, here I have information for steel pipes, and this one is for Schedule 80. You can see they've got all the different dimensional properties inside of here that you can use. If you want them in millimeters instead, you can click on the button and it'll give you the values for those as well. And the important information here is the external diameter, the nominal thickness, and the weight in length or pounds per foot. This is a linear weight. Okay, I am back over to Creo Parametric. Now continuing on, here we have the shape type, and here it's going to be a straight type. You could also use this checkbox if you wanted this to be flexible as well, but I'm not going to make a flexible steel type. And then for the different corners, we're going to allow bends. And let's check the box here for fittings. This radio button over here allows you to set the default corner type, but the default corner type that I want is going to be for a bend. If you wanted it to have allowable corners with miter cuts, you could do that as well. And I'm going to do that for the rectangular duct that I will create next. Now for the weight per length, in my set of units, I have calculated that to be 1.24. Here we have the different allowable bend radii. Maybe I want to allow this to have bend radii 4, 6, 8. I can add other additional values in there. And here we have our bend angles. Since we're not allowing miter cuts, those fields are grayed out. If you go to the Design Rule tab, you can specify maximum length. So for example, in inches, maybe I want to say that the maximum allowable length is going to be 2,000 inches. Here's the minimum segment length. Maybe I want to increase that. And the reason that you set up these different design rules is that later on, after you've routed your pipelines, you can run the different pipe checks and it'll check it against the values that you have specified in here for your design rule parameters. You can see some of the other different ones: maximum number of bends, minimum bend separation, minimum and maximum bend angles, so forth and so on. And there is another tab here for defined where you can create your own user defined parameters for this line stock if you so desired. But this is good for how I want to configure the first one. Let's click the OK button. And if you ever want to see the different line stock that you have in your particular model, you can choose a list. It's going to open up this dialog box, which will list the ones that you have configured. Let's close out of here. Now for the second one, I'm going to make some rectangular duct. And for my rectangular duct, I thought, hey, you know what? Let's try to make some rectangular duct for John McClane going through in Die Hard. And one thing to mention, in researching this video, I found out that that ductwork that they had in there is kind of made up. In architecture, they have a term that they call Nakatomi space for all the different areas that you see in buildings and movies that wouldn't actually exist. But if you go to engineeringtoolbox.com again, here you can see the commonly used rectangular duct sizes in air handling ventilation systems. And also in the research of this, I was trying to figure out, okay, John McClane going through there, what would the width be? And looking up the information, there is something called biachromial diameter, which is a fancy way of saying that's the measurement of shoulder width. And according to some CDC research, they say that the average American man has a shoulder width of 16.1 inches, which I feel is like kind of narrow. I know that my shoulders are way narrower than that, but I'm kind of a big guy. Anyhow, I decide that, hey, let's give John McClane about 24 inches of width, and I'm going to have it be about 16 inches high. And we can see that that is actually a preferred width and height for common air handling ventilation systems. For the thickness of the material, also from engineeringtoolbox.com, I'm going to choose the biggest gauge thickness available from the SMACNA list of ductwork, and that comes out to a thickness of 0.0187. Back over to Creo Parametric. Let's create our new line stock, and I'm going to call this my Nakatomi duct. And again, we have our stock number. You can change that value you want to, and this is going to be made out of steel and grade, and you can choose the material file if you want, but since I already showed that, I'm going to go past that. We'll change the cross section to rectangular. Again, we're going to leave it as hollow and solid. And for the height of this, it's going to be a value of 16. For the width, let's use a value of 24. By the way, my assembly is in inches, so that's the value I'm going to choose. We're going to have right angles on all the different sides. And the thickness is going to be 0.0187 for the thickness. And for the shape type, it's going to be straight. This isn't going to have bends. It's going to have miter cuts in it instead. So let's turn off the bends and automatically change the miter cut to the default, since that's the only corner type that I'm allowing. For figuring out the weight per length, I jumped over to MathCAD. So here I have my MathCAD worksheet. Just a reminder, you can download MathCAD Express for free in order to do things like this. So I punched in the density of steel and figured out for this particular material, here is the volume of an inch of length. And so it turned out to be about 0.4185 pounds per inch. So let's plug in that value, 0.4185. And for the miter cut lengths, these are really, really small values. I'm going to go with, let's go miter cuts with like 16 and 24 and some multiples of that, 32, 48, and so on. and the miter cut numbers. Let's plug in those different values in here. And just like before, you have the different design rules where you can plug in your different maximum overall length and maximum number of segments and so forth, minimum branch angle, whatever. And again, the define tab. But that's all that we need for configuring our rectangular line stock. So I will click OK. And for the last one that I'm going to do, I'm going to make some flexible hose. And for my flexible hose, I went over to McMaster Car, which is McMaster.com, and looked up some static dissipative silicone rubber opaque tubing. And I decided that I wanted to configure the one with the 3/4 inch OD and 1/2 inch ID. So let's figure out that information. Once again, let's click the create button. And for the line stock, I'm just going to use the McMaster car number for that one. Oops. And hit the enter key. And I'm not going to bother changing the pipe or for the material. Let's plug in this silicone rubber. And for the cross section, we're going to go with circular, hollow. Here we're going to change this to flexible and turn off the straight option. And I didn't figure out the weight per unit length. But let's go to the design rule tab. And here we have the minimum bend radius. For this one, it was listed on here as 0.25. So I do want to plug in that value over there. That is good. Let's click the OK button. And in that way, I have created three different line stocks to use. So I click the edit button. I can go and I can change my schedule 80 with my nominal pipe size of 4 inches, my Nakatomi duct, and also my flexible hose that I created. And with that, that is one piece of setup necessary in order for me to be able to route pipelines manually in Creo Parametric. I hope you enjoyed this video. For more information, please visit www.creowindchill.com. If you learned something from this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you like this video, please click the subscribe button to be informed when new videos are uploaded. Thank you very much.